It is.
I had a very interesting childhood, being born in a very small town like Tripunduthura. Tripunduthura is very close to Ernakulam, central Kerala. And that place is very known for the temples that they have. Every 2 minutes you walk, there is a temple. And each of these temples have an annual festival, we call it Utsavam. During those times, there's humongous amount of activities and festivities happening. Array of elephants, like 15 elephants doing the pradakshina. That is what one of the part of the rituals every day in all the temples during the festival time. The very first drawing that I made was of this elephant who carries the god on the head, and they come to every house and you do the offering. There are so many interesting characters you've seen, and they come in as ready caricatures. So, it's not like, you have to do something to them. They come with their own quirks and stuff like that. There was this small shack where every evening I used to go and buy this candies. My father used to get me this candy. So there was this bald guy who would have a toothless smile, and, he would give me these two candies free. And there was this another guy who would always, I haven't seen his shirt. Torso and under. I've only seen him till here because he would be standing on the veranda of this first floor the building, and he would tell me when I'm walking like this in the morning to school, he would say, "Arey jawan ki tarah chalo, you should walk like a jawan." So every time he would say that, and I would walk like straight only for that bit. Then there are these guys. I've seen him walking with those cloth bag where you carry vegetables. But this guy would be carrying radio inside, and he would be playing music. And as he walks, there's music playing, and you wonder, where is the music coming from? Then I discovered one day that, this is this guy carrying this. The only other time I see him is on the top of elephants. So it's a very, because he would be one of the priests who are privileged to sit on the elephants when the offerings happen and stuff. Overall, when Malgudi days I was seeing, I didn't find anything odd about it. It was real for me, because that's exactly the world I was living in. The other influential character in my life is my father. We are like friends. He's slightly short, and I became tall very quickly. I used to put my arms around my father's shoulder, and he also used to walk around like that in the town. And so he told me a lot of stories. For me, I knew the Puranas much before other kids in my class knew. And I used to go for this Purana quiz and all those things, and I used to win. So this is another area of growing up. Used to, put in so many seeds of these characters in my mind. I mean, even in my feature concept that I'm working on, there is so much of his storytelling that's influenced certain characterization. He used to also take me for all the painting competitions. One of the painting competitions I went to, my father was waiting outside. I was drawing and then painting. And after the painting was done, this man from nowhere came and told me that, you should go to NID. It didn't make any sense. I said, "What is NID? So he said, "National Institute of Design in Ahmedabad." This was in 1990. And 91 is when I got through to NID. So at the end of my 3 years, after getting good enough exposure in video filmmaking and graphic design, animation, exhibition design, etc., I wanted to take up exhibition design or video, because I had met a few seniors who were really good in their work, and I thought this is the way to be as good as them. But my jury came and told me that, you know, Suresh, you will have to take up animation because you are an introvert. You cannot manage people. You know, so you quietly sit in a corner, sit with your light box and make films. I dreaded it for a moment, but I kind of took it on. One of the films that I remember very clearly is, one is the sound breakdown exercise that I did. To pull water from a well, to draw water from a well, this pot is dropped into the well. The pot is always, if you notice, it is strangled, like, you know, it is always like on a leash. So my story was basically about the pot freeing itself. It was basically a line test machine. You had to you draw with pencil, and you, after you break down the sound. There was another film that I did as my final project, which was called Smoke, where there are two tribes. One is very paranoid, and the other ones make a lot of noise. The paranoid tribe kind of sees a smoke in their village, and they feel that the other tribe has attacked them and destroyed something, and that's how the smoke is coming. There's a huge fight happening between the people, a lot of casualties. And the camera kind of goes and tracks what really happened. It was just a guy sitting and smoking somewhere. So it's that sort of an exaggeration that, you know, most of these riots that happen are based on rumors, and they really don't have anything concrete. But, you know, this an experiment that I did with cell animation. It was a 4.5-minute film. One of the last cell animated films done at NID using Oxbury camera. And my diploma project was a series of films on AIDS, which we had done for the government of Kerala. Those were also very experimental in nature, but pretty interesting. But I felt I felt a need for doing this project in Kerala, especially because the ostracization of AIDS patients was huge in Kerala. Being in NID for 5 years, you know, you have such a support system and the community is there with you. You never depend on anything from outside. Generally, people, by the end of the education, they feel they become an artist, or they become very purist in a certain way. You know, that I will make only films that will help society. We shouldn't do anything commercial. You know, if there is money involved, that's all bad. And it's very strange kind of philosophies kind of influencing you at that point. Basically, there's a fear to go out and do work because you don't know how people would react to you, whether they will accept you or they will say that, no, you're a bohemian and, you know, we don't want to take you in our company. There are various ways I could contribute in a project. And I didn't want to limit myself to somebody who would just come and do it and his animated scene and go back home. So what do? So that is when I found this job at Western Auto Interactive, where I was appointed as a senior graphic designer, but I was doing animation. I was doing various things for these games that they were developing in-house. I was very active partner in creating them. So while at Western Outdoor Interactive, I was approached by Famous Studios to create animated content. There was no brief on what they want to do or exactly what product that we should make, and I said that, you know, why don't we do animated versions of Amar Chitra Katha stories. So what I did was I gathered this very enthusiastic bunch of people together. There was Geetanjali in the team. Geetanjali was there when I was interning with Ram Mohan, so knew her. There was Vaibhav from NID. Vaibhav just about finished then. So I asked him to also come on board. There were a few other animator friends and a few of them. Like, we were around 10 to 12 people. I gathered them and we set up a team. And when I was asked how much would it cost to create a 25-minute episode, I told Mr. Roonta, who is the owner of Famous, that I'll do it in 5 lakhs. So what is the first story? I said, let's make stories on Shivaji. Four months down the line, we had almost exhausted all the funds and the film was not yet done. So obviously the management of Famous got a little shaky and said, what is happening, you know? Let's do one thing. Let's take whatever you've done, finish it, and you know, take it to some people where we can sell. I said, selling? I don't know. I have no idea how to sell and all. He said, oh, you don't know? I said, yeah, but you never asked me also. Okay, we'll try. And then we went out to the market and asked some channels and stuff. They said, see, for live action episodes, we pay around 75,000 to 1 lakh. And that too, if it is really good. But animation, no. For peak time, we cannot take it. And we cannot even pay this. And we've already spent some 5 lakhs on the whole thing. So they pulled the plug and told me that, Suresh, you pack up the team. And because we cannot, I think it's going on losses. We don't have a proper marketing proposal here. So we cannot sustain with this. Then I took a decision in my mind. I'm going to take a hard call. And I'm going to tell the director of Famous that, you know, I'm going to run it. And I'm going to bring in the money. So no more investments. I'm going to bring the money. Then I started going to the advertising agencies, knocking at the creative directors' cabins and showing them my work and taking on small projects like animatics and stuff and doing it myself without the help of the rest of the people in the beginning. So that at least the agencies gained confidence in us. And then I gave the organization the name House of Animation first. Then attached Famous's name also, Famous House of Animation. And we also tried our luck with the channels. So we, in Channel B, we did a lot of IDs. One of them was Simpu. And Simpu got very popular. And luckily, they liked it, like the entire series of Simpu. So after gaining confidence from the agencies, we were able to soft launch new mediums like stop motion animation and 3D animation in different forms, cutout animations, all these different forms of animation we were able to introduce. And I think Amaron battery commercials launched clay animation in a big way, at least in the commercial world.
Two yuppies in middle management race, one with brains, one with face. Tortoise car was on finance money, rabbit brought papa's Lamborghini. He drove on 120 car speed, was in the lead, so got down for chai. Lamborghini refused to start. Rama jaane why. Tortoise came first with ease. Told secretary and all colleagues. His car was right, battery was wrong. My Amaron lasts long, really long. Bolo.
Last long, really long. Last long, really long.
Ding, tang, ding, tang, ding, tang, dish.
We introduced a lot of folk art styles. Even in 3D animation, I think in the early 2000, the people had major bias against 3D animation, CGI, because that was the time people had started working on 3D animation, and they were not very refined with the rendering quality, etc., etc. The animation was also very robotic and not very fluid like how you see in 2D. So we were able to change certain definitions for people by coming up with new looks within 3D animation, which got even globally accepted.
Scream
the first ever music video in animation. All these projects we had taken up not looking at money, but we knew that they are creating certain benchmarks. So we did a lot of things not thinking money, whether it is feasible. The short film that we had done, Freedom Song, is still one of the finest examples of short films that is produced from the country. Famous House of Animation, even though we wanted to do variety of work which is not limited to animation, combination of live action and animation, and you know, animating with real people. The moment we started Eeksaurus in 2009, we kind of opened those opportunities also. We started getting such kind of avenues where we were able to shoot with real people, film real people, and combine animation, stop motion animation with real sets, etc., etc. So that was a big transition point in terms of us expanding our canvas. Whenever there are no animation scripts from the advertising agencies coming to us, we work on our animation short films. And the money that we bring in from the production is invested back into the company so that there is good content coming out of this place. And it clearly should keep making benchmarks in the Indian animation scenario itself. When I get a brief, I look at various options. Sometimes the brief might demand me to plant a tree and, you know, shoot it for 20 years, every day, 3 frames, and for 20 years I should shoot so I can show the growth of that. That might be the best way to do it, for convincing people that, you know, this is most apt for the story that has come as part of the brief. But that is impossible. The client will say, no, you don't have 20 years. We'll be done and over. We have 3 weeks. So then you start thinking about what can be done in 3 weeks. Then you suggest, can we make a miniature tree, which like a bonsai, and, you know, do the whole thing? They said, no, that is not the kind of thing I don't mind you doing it, but we don't have that sort of budget. Then you come up with a thing that, okay, so can we, we'll make a computer-generated tree, and it'll kind of fit in your budget, and but we'll stylize it in such a way that it'll be unique. People wouldn't have seen it in that sense. So they'll say, okay, that we are okay with. So that's how we come up with a style. So it is a very organic process rather than something that where I look like this stubborn child who will say that, you know, I want to do this film in stop motion only, and stop motion only, and I want this much money, and I want this much time. That doesn't work in this industry. So that has been, that there I always apply design thinking to come up with solutions. And that has resulted in, you know, coming up with so many varieties of styles for our films. We have done close to 350 films, and each and every film looks different from another one, mainly because of this reason. It is not a conscious decision to make our films look different, but it is a conscious decision to make every story stand out differently. And while selecting this style, which works perfectly for the brief and the story, there is also this responsibility that I don't want to show people something that we have done before. I want to show them something new. And it has to be unique. And it has to also uplift the sensibilities of even the animation fraternity as a whole. The second aspect I would look at is definitely in an international scale, I have a lot of exposure in seeing work, being in juries and whatever. I have to, again, create benchmark. When international community sees it, they should be wondering, oh, this sort of work happens in India. So there comes another responsibility, which is something that may not be known by my team members here. They may like something that I have seen 100 times internationally, but my choice would be, I would come up with something unique which is not even seen there.
Free. When we join hands, miracles happen.
So today when I'm choosing a style, I have this inbuilt mechanism in me which will not allow me to go for the regular. But at the same time, I will not go for something so niche that people will not get it, you know, people will not understand it. I would do necessary in dumbing down to the style that and the storytelling way. So that people get it, people understand it. How many of the 2D animators in India are exposed to camera? How many of them know how to lens a scene? What is the correct way to light that particular shot? So unless and until they get that exposure from live action, where you actually put so many lights and this and that and adjust and get that perfect visual, they will not understand the pains to get that sort of a picture. It's easier for them. They don't need 10 people to run around with a light or a cutter or whatever to get a scene lit. They have lights which can be controlled digitally in their computer. But they need to know that. This year we did the film, 4 films for on the subject of safety for women, and we created them to make people aware of the Mumbai police helpline number.
Oh. When wild animals trouble you, the all-new porcupine jacket can help. Coming soon in 2214. Until then, when in trouble, please call 103. Please remember, 103.
And today we are talking about how we can put it on national TV or cinema and stuff. So these are all eye-opening experiences and which inspires us to do more for the society. So which is something that I would urge many of my colleagues also to come on board and do for the society. Then we can improve a lot in our social fabric.